So to avoid the space complexity in the Anderson's array-based queuing lock, we're going to use a linked list representation for the queue. So the size of the queue is going to be exactly equal to the dynamic sharing of the lock. And this particular linked list-based queuing lock algorithm is due to the authors of the paper that I've prescribed for you in this reading list, namely Melacrummy and Scott. And so sometimes this particular queuing lock is also referred to as the MCS lock. So the lock data structure, the head of the queue, is a dummy node. It is associated with every lock. So every lock is going to have this dummy node associated with it, and we'll initialize this dummy node to indicate there is no lock requesters presently for this particular lock. So this pointer is pointing to nil. Nobody's got the lock. And there are two fields for every queue node for a requester. So every new requester is going to get this queue node. And in this queue node, there are two fields. One field is the guarded field. And guarded is basically a Boolean, and it says whether I have the lock or not. If it is true, I've got it. If it is false, I don't have it yet. And the next field in the queue node is pointing to my successor in the queue. So if I came in and I requested the lock, I get into the queue, and if a successor comes along and requests the lock, he gets queued up behind me. So that's this basic data structure. Every queue node is associated with a requester. The dummy node that we start with is representing the lock itself. And since we are implementing a queue, fairness is automatically assured. The requesters get queued up in the order in which they make the request. And so we have fairness built into this algorithm, just like the Anderson's array-based queue lock. As I said before, we initialize the lock to nil, indicating there are no requests yet. And let's say that I come along and request a lock. I don't have to wait because currently there's nobody in the queue, and therefore I get the lock right away, and I can go off into the critical section and start executing the critical section code that is associated with this particular lock. So what I would have done when I came in to make this lock request is to get this queue node and make the lock data structure point to me. And I'll also set the next pointer to nil to indicate that there's nobody after me. And once I've done that, I know that I've got the lock, and I can go off into the critical section and do whatever I need to do.